Hey everyone, Zeddy here again today with a brand new video. And before we get on to the topic of the video, I just wanted to give a huge thank you to everybody. Yesterday we had, you know, that pretty personal story that I told on my, you know, blacklisting video, and the support and all the kind words and the love and meant a lot. It meant a ton to me in the comments. You have no idea how much it means. I really appreciate so much of the support you guys continue to show me, and it's really hard to talk about a lot of stuff, especially like the mental health stuff. You know, it's not easy, but if my putting that stuff out there can help just one person, it's totally worth it. So thank you for that. And like, we got a bunch of subs from it. We got like, we're well over 18,000 now. So I'm pretty excited about when we get to 20K. I'll try and plan something big for 20K. I don't know when that'll happen, but again, we'll try and plan something big. But again, I just wanted to thank you guys so much. It means everything to me. Anyways, let's get going to the topic of the video. And it's a question I get asked all the time, like every day on stream. So I'm like, you know what? I'll have a video where I can direct people to it. And that's the mini set. What is the deal with the mini set being added to Hearthstone? When is it coming out? What is it? How do I prepare for it? So let's cover all of that. Let's cover all that in this very video to get as well prepared based on the information that at least I'm aware of that is public knowledge, and, you know, help as much as I can until there's another official announcement of anything. So what is the mini set? A mini set is basically like a card infusion into the current expansion. Every expansion going forward, you're going to have the initial launch of cards like we saw in November with Darkmoon Faire. And then halfway through the expansion, we're going to see 35 cards added into the expansion. So like last year, we had Descent of Dragons, right? And they released a 35-card adventure halfway through it. It's kind of like that, but different, because this isn't an adventure. It's like a card infusion. The 35 cards will simply be added into the Darkmoon Faire expansion itself. So it's literally just thrown into there. The current pool of cards, it's just tossed in there. So whatever the current card total is, you add 35 total to it. And then the only way you can gain access to these 35 new cards is to either open Darkmoon Faire packs. So not by buying an adventure, it's by buying Darkmoon Faire packs. Or if you have some from already not opened, opening those, or crafting the cards as you normally would. And we don't know the rarity breakdown for the mini set yet. We don't know. But if you look at Galakrond's Awakening, again, as an example, that was a 35-card adventure last year. And we saw it had 4 legendaries, 4 epics, 12 rares, and 15 commons. So there's a good chance it'll be something similar to that. The rarity distribution in expansions has been very consistent the last couple of years, so it could be that, but it might not be, so who knows. But we might only have to open up 4 more epics, 4 more legendaries, which in the grand scheme of things isn't a ton. How do you prepare for this? What should you do to prepare for the mini set? So let's say you're like me. You're a complete whale. You've bought everything, all the pre-orders. You have every single card from Darkmoon Faire. You have your Darkmoon Faire coin. You're a total whale. You have all the cards. Don't open any packs. Just save every Darkmoon Faire card pack you have. If you look, I'll show. I have like 40, almost 45 packs I've acquired either through like quests, the season end rewards. I play Arena. I get Arena packs through there. I'm just going to save them because when the expansion launches, I can just open them and get new cards. And what's important to know is duplicate protection. Duplicate protection exists. That means when you open a pack, you cannot get the same rare or common or legendary or epic that you already have, right? So for me, when I open these packs, I will only get rares I don't have. I'll only get commons I don't have, and epics and legendaries. And since I have every Darkmoon Faire pack, every pack I open will just be all the new cards. So once I open 4 legendaries in packs, I will have all of them. Once I open, I guess, 4 times 2, 8 epics, I'll have all of them, and so on and so on. So that's important to know. But then there's the situation, right? What if I have all the commons and rares, like a lot of people will, because commons or rares are what you complete very quickly, but I'm missing a bunch of epics and legendaries. This is where it gets tricky, right? Because when you open the Darkmoon Faire packs, you're going to have a chance of opening either one of the new legendaries or one of the legendaries you're missing. And same with the epics. And chances are, the legendaries and epics you're missing are ones you don't want, for the most part. They're probably ones you haven't bothered to open. Like, you don't want Maxima Blastenheimer, because it's, you know, it's kind of a meme card. But when you open the Darkmoon Faire packs, you might open that, because duplicate protection is only about cards you don't own. So you'll have to, basically, it's kind of like a case by case. You're going to have to evaluate, you know, if I'm only missing legendaries and epics I don't want, like, only missing those, then just save the packs, because then you just increase the odds that you'll open a pack with a legendary and epic that you'll actually want from the mini set. But if it's some that you do want and some that you don't want, then maybe just keep opening them and opening them until you get every legendary or epic that you do want, and then hold off. So basically, the only way I would say not to open Darkmoon Faire, like to the reason not to save Darkmoon Faire packs, is if you're missing a bunch of legendaries and epics that you want. You might as well open them, because you'll have a chance at getting them now, and because when the Darkmoon Faire mini set comes out, you're gonna be, it'll be mixed in with all the garbage. So you might as well just open up what you want, try and get what you want, and, you know, at least have the fun of opening packs. But if you basically have almost everything you want, there's like just a couple of cards you're missing, then just save the packs, and then any other situation, just open them. Just open them, and until you're in that spot. So hopefully that helps. That helps explain the mini set, like, distribution, like, the pack opening strategy. But there's one last thing I wanted to really go over, is this isn't an adventure. This isn't an adventure, and some people are turned off by that. Because the adventure, you could just spend $20, right? And then you get everything. And that'd be way cheaper than you're gonna have to get a bunch of packs and open it. But there's some pros and cons to it. So, to actually get all the mini set stuff, you probably would have to spend more money, in theory, by buying packs and getting all the cards. But there's one big difference, and I saw this complaint all the time, is that with adventures, you would have to unlock every wing, right, to get the cards. You couldn't craft anything. So let's use for an example the Galakrond's Awakening. The amazing Reno, the mage hero card, really crazy hero card, is locked into the wing 4. And if you couldn't save up the gold or spend the money to get the adventure, there was no way for you to get Reno. You can't craft it. You can't craft adventure cards. Risky skippers in that realm. And some people just can't afford it. And then they can't craft that card, and it feels really bad. With the mini set infusion, day one, right out the gate, you can craft whatever card from the mini set. You don't have to unlock a wing, any of that stuff. So you get a bit more freedom. You're able to craft whatever card. The issue is, compared to an adventure, you don't get the adventure content that some people enjoy. A lot of people don't care about it, but some people enjoy it. And you don't get, you know, the cheaper, more efficient way of acquiring the cards. So keep that in mind when you're like, if you're critiquing it and you're like, you're mad about the fact it's not an adventure. There is the pro and con to it. I would prefer it to be an adventure. I like the adventure content stuff. I like the fact that it's a bit cheaper. But again, I'm someone that has all the cards, so it's just more efficient for me. But for someone who wants to, like, pick and choose their cards, I think this is much better. Because especially for a budget player, they can just craft whatever they want, even if the crafting system is a little bit junky. But, you know, at least there's that flexibility. So that's the information I thought I would give. In terms of, like, a release date, we don't know. I'm going to assume that it's going to come mid to late January, probably on a Tuesday or Thursday. My rough estimate would be between, like, Thursday, January 19th, with, like, the latest being January 28th. Maybe it'll be first week of February, we don't know. But that would be basically the midway point since the last expansion. So there's a good chance we might get, like, a balance patch, maybe something minor before then, and then come late to mid-January, we could see this mini set drop. So that hopefully covers it. We kind of have an idea of when it'll come out, what you should do to prepare for it, what it means, the pros and cons of it. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. Have a great day, and stay salty, my friends.